I hope you're enjoying the speed dating.
We've met some likely contenders thus far.
Oh, right. Yeah.
And in 2025, when we can touch each other, it's going to be a great time.
It's going to be great.
One of the things, when did you guys know that Billy Joel was joining the cast in season two?
He's basically a cast member. Sorry, go ahead, Erin.
Well, no, I feel like this is yours to answer because it's
Billy Joel. I have to tell just a quick, I'm going to make it very short, story about Billy Joel. This is just basically a compliment to Eric. My very first day on set, it's the scene in season one where Butcher's convincing Hughie to put a bug in the Seven Tower. They encouraged me to improvise. I said, you know who my favorite musician is? James Taylor. Eric was like, that's great. Make it a list. James Taylor, Simon and Garfunkel, Billy Joel. And then something about Billy Joel just stuck, which was incredible. So then we altered other scenes, like the scene where Robin dies. You know, the last thing I say to her is, don't you ever besmirch Billy Joel. That wasn't in there originally. And now I'm seeing it in the season two teaser trailer, and it's just become a part of the show and about Hughie. And that is all from like a dumb bit that Eric and I worked out on my first day. So the fact that he encourages that kind of actor participation and he lets things happen organically in that way is just so cool. And I'm just so happy that he's joined the cast. It's been really fun.
Amazing.
One of the things about season two is you guys had an extra 3 days, officially an extra 3 days of shooting per episode.
We did?
I think you did. I think you went, because I spoke to Eric. He said you guys went to 12.
Okay, 12. Yeah.
So I'm just curious, did you notice, what did the extra time allow you guys to pull off or help in terms of making the show?
Well, clearly, I didn't realize. But there was a lot of improv this year. There was season one, but maybe it was also because we were more confident with each other and in our character's skin. But the improv this year was great, and that was really fun. And I bet you that having takes to just play and improv would have been, the amount of takes would have been truncated without the extra days.
And what I like about this season too is in the editing of it too, because we got all the exposition out of the way in season one. We let each scene breathe. You get to really know these people a lot more, which is awesome.
Yeah.
One of the things that I think everyone loves about the show is that every episode has a what the fuck moment. You know, something that you are just, you know, jaw on ground. How much do you guys find out about those in advance? And how much is it like you're reading the script for the first time and you're hearing about, are you serious?
I would say half and half. I would say occasionally Kripke would be like, y'all, this is going to happen this year, or this might happen this year, pending Amazon's approval. But I definitely also have had moments reading the script where I'm texting Jack or one of our other castmates, and I'm like, I love our job so much. Like, fatal cunnilingus, a whale carcass, and what else in one TV show, and have so many of those moments. And it's going to be hard to migrate to any other job for the rest of my life that doesn't have that shock value.
You're telling me nobody's exploding in front of me today? That's what you're telling me? Okay, interesting. This is a weird set. especially with Hughie, like Eric loves to torture me and the character. So every time I see something on a page, I go through a whole emotional rainbow of just like, oh God, I'm gonna have to do that. But that's gonna be super cool and you're never gonna do anything like that again. So I just look forward to every script, but I do kind of look at it through my fingers sometimes because I'm just like, what am I doing this episode?
One of the things though, and especially in season two, I don't want to get any spoilers, but there's a lot of blood in one of those episodes. I mean, an awful lot of blood, and it's splattered all over people. What the hell is it like actually getting ready to film a scene like that? Because it can't be comfortable being in that kind of thing.
No, I remember I had a day where I was in my trailer and I was like covered in all the blood that's in my hair. There's like brain and stuff in my hair. And I went to like just lie down for a second. I didn't want to get the blood on the couch in the trailer, so I put a little towel down. When I got up, it got up with me. It was that sticky. I had to, I think, Erin, were you there in the makeup trailer when I ran in? And I'm like, guys, help me. I can't get the towel off my head.
I wish I was, but I wish I were. I do know there were so many days where I observed Jack covered in blood, just looking dead inside. Like, just between takes, like sitting in a tent, just like hot Toronto humidity, covered in blood for the like several days in a row, and just looking
dead. That was the difference between season one and season two. Season one, I get covered in blood. Ah, my reaction. Cut into the hair and makeup trailer. I get it all off of me. If we got it, we got it. We can move on. Season two, and then there's no time cut. It's just, we keep going. So I would be in blood for weeks as opposed to like a day or a few hours. That was a huge difference.
Right. You guys have already been, I'm very happy you guys have been picked up for a season three. And I'm definitely curious, when did you guys first hear that there was going to be a season three? And what have you heard through the grapevine in terms of things?
Well, we heard today that the female has a fondness for old Hollywood musical movies, and that's revealed in season three. Mm-hmm. That is the absolute extent of my knowledge. Season three. When did we find out?
We found out. I don't know. It wasn't quite pandemic time, I don't think. I think it was slightly before that. And we had to keep it a secret a bit. But we just feel super happy to be able to go back to a show where this is the best job I've ever had, hands down, period. And to have that potentially waiting at the end of the pandemic rainbow is just very, very nice. I feel exceptionally lucky.
On that note, I have to go. I just want to say congrats on the episodes I've seen of season two. You guys have fun speed dating. Thank you so much for your time.
You're awesome, man.
Later.
See you later.